Now that we have a ton of dimensional shards, thanks to that builder over in our new dimension, we can finally start to look at completing some of the remaining quests here in Chapter 6. Now, all of those quests are going to require Draconium Ingots, and so I think we should probably start here by getting just a bunch of them. Along that same line, we should probably look at increasing the amount of artificial purple dye that we can store in here, because I think that's going to be our limiting factor. For example, if I wanted like 256 draconium, yeah, the only thing we're missing is the 656 artificial purple dye. And so I think it's time to take out the flint downgrade. That's going to increase the amount that this draw can hold by quite a substantial amount. In fact, at that point, we can probably also take out these obsidian upgrades as well, taking this draw's capacity up to 2048 again, the basic amount, which I think for now is probably a good amount for us. It is going to start to burn through some of our lapis here, but I think that's fine. And it looks like all of our beets have kind of already been processed over into red dye anyway. So let's start, I guess, with like 64 draconium ingots. That should be enough to get us through a couple of the first quests here, at least the Wyvern Core, potentially the 9 basic fusion crafting injectors. We should probably teach our system how to make some of this stuff. For example, I feel like we definitely are going to need to teach it how to make the Draconic Cores and also how to make the Wyvern Cores here. On top of that, it's going to be a lot easier for us to be able to just request these basic fusion crafting injectors. They do require blocks of iron, but that's also an easy enough recipe to teach. So I'll put all these in over here. Perfect. And then can we request 9 of these? Is that what it said? Yeah. I'm going to assume no. Oh no, we totally can. Start. Perfect. Okay. So these are pretty interesting. They do all need power. As janky as it's going to be, chat, I think temporarily, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them down in the middle of the room here. We will find, I think, a more permanent kind of place for these in the future. But for now, if we do something like this, and I have obviously miscalculated how many we have here. We'd have 12, we have 9. But if we do something like that, they do all require power. And we also do have to get, I believe, like a block for the middle. I do forget the name of it. I think it's the fusion crafting core. Yes, that definitely seems like the block that we're after here. So let's request that draconic core, which shouldn't take a second. Perfect. And then we could throw that down right about here. Nice. I think these, I don't think there's a specific kind of design layout for this. They just have to be nearby to the draconic evolution fusion crafting core. Right, and then it has to have the basic fusion crafting injectors close enough to it. We'll then go and, like I said, temporarily, we'll do something like this until we get a better place for it, chat. This is very, very temporary. But that's going to allow us to easily run power to all of these. And I don't think any of these are going to need more than 10,000 redstone flux per tick. So over here, we can just set all of those to insert. So those should start getting power. They don't have power right now because these, if I remember correctly, were a little bit janky in that they don't actually start to be able to hold power until you actually start a recipe. So now, if we wanted to do this next quest, which we can do just as soon as we get one Wyvern Core, let's request one of those. Perfect. So now if we wanted to complete this quest here, we need 7 Wyvern Fusion Crafting Injectors. These are made with 4 diamonds, 1 block of draconium, 2 draconium cores, and a wyvern core. So, diamond-wise, we're doing fine. We've got over 1,000 diamonds. The block of draconium is something I will teach my system to make, not because it's a particularly hard recipe, but it's just an easy way of us requesting 9 draconium. And for now, I will just request the 1. Start. What else do we need here? We also needed 2 draconic and 1 wyvern core. So draconic times 2. Perfect. And then Wyvern times one, which we already have actually, but that's fine. So if we do one, two, no, you go, okay, so this is also awkward. By default, you'll see in the bottom right here, the fusion crafting injectors are set to a single item mode inactive. If we shift right click, you can change them to single item mode active, which I'm going to do temporarily. If you're trying to do crafts individually, this makes sense because now we can do one, two, three, four. If you have it set to single item mode deactive and then you try and put like a diamond on there, it will take the whole stack, which in some cases is good because sometimes you want to automate this and craft like a few things in bulk. But for now, we'll set them to single stack so we can put four diamonds on. We can put on one block of draconium, one wyvern core, and two draconic cores. So if we put this guy in like so, we now have the option to start this craft. Now, it does require 265,000 redstone flux. However, given our current power production rate, I don't think that's going to take too long. So if we click start, we should hopefully see power begin to fill up in the crafting injectors. Perfect. And that's going to slowly but surely charge up the crafting core. And also it's going to increase the size of these blue balls around all the items. And then once it hits 100%, which will hopefully do any second now, we should see those blue balls fly to the center, and then it's going to slowly but surely craft up into a Wyvern fusion crafting injector. Nice. And you can use these kind of like in place of these, right? So different recipes have different requirements for which fusion crafting injectors they need, right? For example, the next quest here, once we get seven of these Wyvern fusion crafting injectors, is to make four awakened draconium blocks. The awakened draconium blocks are made in the same fashion, but you'll see at the top here it says tier Wyvern. So in order to complete this recipe, all seven of the items have to be on Wyvern pedestals. However, for the previous tier, right, for making Wyvern fusion crafting injectors, they have to be on, if we look in JEI, it says basic, but that means basic or better, right? So we can use Wyvern injectors here, we just can't use anything lower than basic, right? So at this point, chat, we need to make six more of these. It's janky because we have to periodically, like, take one of these away and put a new one down, take one away, put one down, take one away, put one down as we go, right? Which means we can't really do these faster than one at a time. But if we leave single stack mode inactive, that means that we can, for example, request six more or five more Wyvern cores. That's going to take us to six Wyvern cores in total, which is how many more we need to get seven Wyvern fusion crafting injectors. And we can put all seven of those into here. And what we can then do on top of that, I believe, is we can also put potentially a hopper directly beneath this guy here. And then also, I guess, another hopper on top of this guy here, like so. And at that point, what this will do is once this is done crafting, and once this turns into a Wyvern fusion crafting injector, it will be deposited into the hopper here. And then if we put more basic fusion crafting injectors and at the top here, that will then be pulled down and sent through, right? So we can kind of automate this process a little bit. And so I think what I'm going to do, in the interest of speed, I guess, or in the interest of automation, what we can do here is we can get five more basic crafting injectors. What that's going to do is that's going to allow us to just put those in there. And so one at a time, these should, actually, I guess we don't need the hopper. I didn't realize you could stack those in the fusion crafting core here. But what that should allow us to do essentially is just fill all of these up with the diamonds and the cores. And then one at a time, while we work on something else, these are going to get processed, right? Because otherwise we'd have to sit here and watch all six of them, right? Which It's fun and all, but you know, we can be doing other things while we wait. So let's take those. Let's request 6 of you. Let's put all 6 of these in here. Let's go ahead and turn off that single stack mode that we enabled a moment ago. And then we just want to put in 6 diamonds into each of these. So 6 in here, 6 in here, 6 in here, and 6 in here. Was that right? Is it 4 or 5? It's 4. We do also then need 6 blocks of Awakened Draconium. Start. And we also need those 6 cores. Those can go in right about there. And then we can throw those in like so. And is that right? Oh, no, we need 6 more Draconic cores. Chat, that's my bad. I forgot we need 2 of these per craft. So we are now missing 26 purple dye. We were so very close to having enough here. And at that point, we actually are out of beets, which is kind of the main limiting factor there. That's not a huge problem. We can rectify that, of course. And in fact, we should have beets, I think, up on the surface. It's been a while, but we do have a little beet farm here. What we can do is we can grab some of our 7,000 bones here. Is our system full? Our system might be full, chat. But we can grab some bones and craft that into bone meal. I know we do have bone meal here, but I want a few stacks of it. And then we can just right-click this a large number of times. And that should get us more than enough beets to kind of kickstart the production of more purple dye. If we just dump those in the system, those should instantly get turned into red dye. And then should also instantly be placed over into the dye mixer. Yeah, look at that. We're already back up at 54 there. Perfect. And so we should have what it takes to get the final 6 draconium cores. We do. Nice. So now if we put that in over here, I'm pretty sure if we click start now, it's going to make all 6 of these back to back. I think that's how that works. I think so long as there's items in here, it will just keep making more of them until it's done. I don't think you have to click start every time. So I'm being told by the Twitch chat that's not how this works. We'll wait for this first one to finish. And then if not, a redstone signal might do the trick. Like, this is almost done. So that's number 2. And then, yeah, the next one doesn't start, unfortunately. If I do that, the next one does start. Okay, cool. So a redstone clock, which just emits a redstone signal periodically, does do the trick there. So despite having only set up the builder a moment ago, chat, we are at 50,000 diamond shards. And so I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go and turn the builder off, because the builder is actually producing kind of too much dimensional shards, too many dimensional shards, right? So for now, I'm going to turn this off. We can always turn it back on again if we do need more shards than 50,000, which we might do going forward. For now, though, until we get more disk drives, that's kind of a bit of a problem for us, because it has started to fill up our disk drives here with dimensional shards, which is less than ideal. And while we wait for the remaining 4 of those to come through, and actually, can I put a sound muffler down around that? I'm assuming that I can. I'm just hopeful it actually works at muffling the sound. It does. Perfect. Okay. So while we wait for that to finish, chat, one thing that I have mentioned a couple of times over the past few streams that I think we should finally get around to making is the Material Stoneworks Factory. This guy is pretty neat, and it's going to allow us to automate the production of sand and glass in a way that's much like faster, right? Basically, what I mean by that is that it's going to allow us to passively automate those and store them in storage drawers, like we're doing with all of our resources here, so that when we need them for a craft, we don't have to then craft them from scratch, like we're doing now. At the moment, if we want to craft like 1,000 sand or 1,000 glass, we first have to get 1,000 sand through the chemical combiner and then smelt 1,000 sand through our redstone furnace. If we instead had a storage drawer full of 2,048 sand, glass that's just been pre-prepared in advance, that is auto-refilled when it's used, that would be a much more ideal situation and would speed up a lot of our auto-crafts going forward. So this guy, fairly easy to make. 2 plastic, 1 crafting table, 1 furnace, 1 machine frame, 1 iron pickaxe, a bucket of both lava and water, and then a pink slime. Most of that we have already good to go. And most of the stuff that we don't have is actually super easy for us to make. Now, plastic-wise, I actually thought We had some. Oh, no, we do. It's just in that tiny, dry rubber form. So let's grab that and smelt that up. We could definitely do, actually, with teaching our system how to make this. And so I'm going to throw that in there. And then while that's smelting, I'm going to quickly teach our system how to make it so that going forward, we can get that much more easily. It's just two crafting recipes. One goes in up here, and the other one goes in over here. And at that point, I think all that we're missing is the bucket of water and the bucket of lava. Lava we should have, I believe, in tank form. We do, yeah. So let's throw that down, grab some lava. And water-wise, we should have an unlimited water source around here by, I was going to say by our aqueous accumulator over there, but I guess we also have this kind of random pool of water right here as well. And a combined chair, that should be everything that we need for the material stoneworks factory. Nice. So basically, the way that this works, I am going to put it in the wall here. And I think we might make two, actually. But so we'll put one right about here. And if we give that power, of course, through our good old friend XNet, what we should see is we should see cobblestone being produced. And the way this works is there are five slots here. Between each of those five slots, there are these little stopped icons. These can be toggled if we left click to different modes. So there's furnace mode, which you'll see smelts the cobble to stone. There's 2x2 craft mode, which right now doesn't do anything. There's grind mode, which turns the cobble to gravel. And then there's 3x3 craft, which would turn it into compressed cobble. And that turns back to stopped. So those are the three modes, and you can do those multiple times. For us here, at least for the first Stoneworks factory, we're going to do grind mode into gravel. We're then going to do grind mode again. That's going to turn the gravel into sand. And then from there, we can go into furnace mode to turn that sand into glass. At that point, how are we doing on antimatter? We still have no white antimatter, right? We have five, but we don't have a lot, which is a little disheartening. I did mention before the possibility of using our builder to kind of mine up a bunch of white antimatter from the overworld here, which is something I think I might do. The only thing I'm thinking about right now, at least, is just coloring in our drawers, because at the moment we do have these two drawers on the end that are not the right color, and I will fix that in the future. For now, though, let's do just this, and let's also get another one of these item stack transfer add-ons to allow us to push all of the glass up into that storage drawer there. So once again, if we shift right click to set that to up, and then if we put that in, I do want to specify here, actually. I think we need to put the glass in like that, then lock it with a key. You can do a lot of configuring here, actually. By default, any of these could go up, right? Like any of these items will be pushed up if this was empty. But now that it's set to just glass, I think we can safely put this in here. And that should hopefully begin pushing that glass, yeah, up into here. And so now, going forward, this will slowly but surely fill up with 2048 glass, right? And so at the cost of just a little bit of power, this is going to continue to make glass. I think if we wanted to, we could even look at making some of these speed and energy upgrades. Let me just check if those do indeed work in here. Yeah, it looks like they totally do. It's a little awkward that you can't use them alongside the push upgrade here. Like, you can't use both of them. Not that I think it necessarily really matters too much. Like, we could take those out. We don't really think need it to be running at a crazy high speed. The fact that it's running passively does mean that eventually this will fill up. And so long as we're not, you know, really requesting a lot of crafts that require glass, it should be fine. We could also do this, of course, for other stuff as well. For example, we could do it for gravel. I am contemplating making one for sand and kind of just fully getting rid of this kind of recipe setup up here. And so I think I might do that. I think we'll make one more material stoneworks factory just to have sand on the end as well, because there are a couple of recipes that we have that require sand that don't require the sand in glass form, right? And we do, again, have basically everything it takes here to make it. So once again, we'll shift-click that. We will put the crate that's not quite the right color up there. We'll put sand into that crate. And yeah, for now, we'll do one of those. And you. At that point, we can fairly safely, I think, get rid of those. But I'll leave that there for now, just in case we do need, like, just in case we do need to craft sand at some point. I think while we shouldn't have to craft sand or glass going forward, the fact that our system can craft sand or glass is probably a good thing. Just in case we do run out of sand or glass here, the system's not going to get clogged up. But over here, we can put in the push add-on. That should push up. This time, we're going to go and just set it to grind and grind, like so. No smelting this time around. And the final piece of the puzzle, of course, is just to give it some power. And at that point, we should now have both automated glass and automated sand. We do. Nice. Now, in the time it took us to set those up, it does appear that these guys are done. They are indeed. Perfect. We have six there, and the seventh one is here. And that is that quest complete. Perfect. The next quest requires four awakened draconian blocks. Each one requires 350 million redstone flux. Now, given that we're not using this dimension, I think we can fairly safely just take this out of here, at which point we can no longer go there, but the dimension is still there. But more importantly, it's no longer using 10,000 redstone flux per tick. And if we need to go back there, we can just put it back into the dimension builder and then head back again, right? That should free up a ton more power for our Wyvern Fusion crafting injectors, which we are going to put down now. We're going to get rid of these guys and replace them with the Wyvern versions. So the question becomes, do we have enough stuff? I think the answer is probably yes. We need six draconium cores. Oh, wait, these are all done at once. You make four at a time. Oh, yeah, no, we should definitely have what it takes here then. So draconium cores, let's take six of those. Draconium bullocks, let's take four of those. And then as for the dragon heart, we do have three, but we can, if we wanted to, make more using the pristine dragon matter. So we can really get as many of those as we like. So yeah, this really shouldn't be a problem, actually, chat. We'll put the dragon heart at the back for symmetry's sake. And then as far as the draconian blocks go, hopefully that's not going to take too long. So once we have the draconian blocks, we can put those in the middle. We can also grab those draconic cores. And again, we do want these stacked individually here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And start. It is possible this takes a little longer now. So yeah, that's going to take like 15 minutes to complete there, which is quite some time. Looking ahead a little bit, the next quest here isn't too bad. It requires a lot less power, so it should be done a lot faster. And only requires five of these Awakened Draconian ingots. The way we get those, I assume, is just by crafting down the Awakened Draconian blocks, and we're about to make 36 ingots worth of Draconian blocks, so we should have enough to make quite a few of these. And then from there, we need, I believe, two of those to make the Extreme Crafting Table. This also requires Nether Stars, which is why at the start of the stream I began running this guy again to get more Nether Stars coming in. And also, at the minute, I believe that that loot fabricator is set to extract draconium. I'm also going to put Nether Stars on that whitelist. It can also pull those into the system as well. And so I think while we wait for this to finish, we can look at crafting up some of these crystal matrix ingots. Also, again, looking even further ahead, the beginning of the next quest line, the first quest here, Jimmy Neutron, is to craft four neutron collectors. And each one of these is quite the craft. It's actually not too bad, but it does require seven crystal matrix ingots, and we need four of them. So we're going to need 28 crystal matrix ingots for that, on top of the six here. So we need, like, what, 34 crystal matrix ingots? They're not super difficult, honestly. They are four diamond lattices, which are made with five diamonds apiece, and then nether stars as well, which we should have quite a large amount of now. And so if we go ahead and just teach our system how to make these, like so, I think at that point we can probably request like 34 of those fairly quickly. So let's see, crystal matrix ingots. Can we get 34 of those? We totally can. It is going to use 68 nether stars, which is pretty pricey, but we do still have 50 left after that. So that is perfectly fine. And you'll see how fast our multi-block crafter is, because it is tearing through those nice and quickly. And then Yeah, the rest of the stuff here is really not going to be too bad. It requires quite a bit of nether quartz, which we should have, quite a lot of iron, and quite a lot of redstone, all of which we should be fairly fine on. We've got 7,000 iron. We have only 800 nether quartz, which is not a ton, and then 10,000 redstone. I do think that it might finally be time to look at making more laser drills to really increase our like resource production. So we now have all of our laser drills and laser bases down. They all have a speed upgrade tier 1, a speed upgrade tier 2, and an energy upgrade tier 1. Eventually, once we get enough diamonds, we will upgrade and put all and give all of them an energy upgrade tier 2. At the moment, we're missing 19 diamonds, so it really shouldn't take too long, I don't think, for us to get the remaining diamonds to give all of these energy tier 2 upgrades as well. But they're all set up, and they should all be pulling all of their ores into the system. And much like with the original laser drill, all of those ores should get processed and, you know, deposited into their respective storage drawer. Over here, this guy is getting there, slowly but surely, 64%. And I think while we wait for that to finish up, one other thing that we definitely should look at automating is the creation of Signalum and Enderium. Up until now, we've been making our Signalum in the smeltery, which does work. However, it's quite slow, right? Not only does it take forever for the magma crucible to break down the redstone, but then on top of that, it also takes forever for the smeltery to pull out all of the signalum, and then it takes even longer for that signalum to solidify into like a gear or an ingot or whatever it is. And on top of all of that, it's not automated. So I think we're going to pivot into using nuclear craft. We can make the signalum ingot with destabilized redstone and this Shibuchi ingot. This is made with copper and silver in the alloy furnace here. So, over in here, if we teach our system in processing mode how to make this, and we actually are finally out of patents, let's go ahead and request like another 32 of those. We can put that into our alloy furnace, like so, and then let's see if we don't have what it takes to make the fluid infuser. So my plan, oh my goodness, we need advanced plating, eh? Okay, that actually shouldn't be too bad. I think we did teach our system how to make machine chassis. We did. Did we teach it how to make advanced plating? We did. Oh, actually, that's perfect. Cool. So it actually shouldn't be too difficult for us to make this at all. Essentially, what I think we might do is we might start to try and leverage, and let me actually bookmark a few things here. We'll bookmark the fluid infuser. We'll also bookmark Signalum and Enderium. But what I was going to say is I think we might start to try and leverage the fact that refined storage can actually store fluids. For example, if we find one of our external storages, and in fact, there's one right on the storage drawer over here, you can toggle this between item mode and fluid mode. So I think what I am probably going to do is I'm probably going to make two more magma crucibles. And much like the thing that we're doing with, you know, our sand and our glass over there, I think we're going to continually export ender pearls and redstone to their own specific magma crucibles and then have those magma crucibles export to their own tanks to kind of always have a backlog of destabilized redstone and resin and ender so that when we want to craft the enderium or signalum ingots, the system can just pull from that tank that already has a buffer of it, as opposed to having to request it, you know, on the fly. So to do that, we need, of course, one fluid infuser. Perfect. We also need two more magma crucibles, which I don't think are going to be too difficult. Yeah, no, we have most everything we need here. That's one. And as long as we can get one more machine frame, which we almost can, we can go ahead and request one. And that's two. Perfect. We'll also request two conversion kits here to upgrade those right away to the higher tier. And then we'll also grab two tanks. Now, I'm not quite sure yet, like what, I might use these open blocks tanks, actually. They're pretty easy to make and they also hold quite a bit. So I think I'll take two of those. I do want two external storages, which perfect. We have those. And then do we have those conversion kits? We do indeed. Perfect. So where do I want to put these is a good question. I think I might put them over here, simply because we already have, like, there's no machine here. So I think what we'll do is we'll have Magma Crucible, Conversion Kit. We'll get speed augments into both of those. And I'm going to make like a stack of redstone reception coils here because we're constantly crafting those individually, which seems like a massive waste. And then we'll do one, two. We'll put tanks. Oh, these connect, right? If I put tanks there, that's not going to work. Can I make that work? Like, can I somehow put something between this to stop that connecting? I don't think I can, right? Like, maybe I could. I think we could do some jankiness where we start putting a bit into here, pick this one up, put the other one down, start putting a bit into there, pick this one up. And I think I might do that. Let's get the connectors down. It's going to be janky, but I think it's going to look a little bit better. So if we do this and this, and connect those up to our pre-existing network cable, like so. Let's go give both of those power. And this list is getting a little insane here, but we'll give both those power like so. And then we also want to export to both of these. So actually, I guess we probably want to move those, right? We want to have the exporters on the back. We want to have these embedded in the wall so we can cover them up with facades later. Like that. And then we want to have external storages here. And can I do this? Can I get rid of that and still leave the external storage there? You totally can. Cool. And then we do want exporters as well. Which again, thankfully we have. So you and you. Let's make sure these are both set to input on the back. And then output. This one's going to output to the right. And auto output is enabled, so it should push things to there. Make sure both of these are set to fluids and fluids, like so. You are going to export redstone, like so. And then let's connect that up. So we should see that starting to fill up with redstone. It is, perfect. Our power is a bit finicky right now because, of course, a lot of our power is being used over here. But if I temporarily set the priority of these two, actually, if I first of all set them to insert on power, but then also give them a priority of like 5, that should put them, for now at least, above the priority of the this thing, which is almost done, actually. So that should be perfect. This should output to here. At that point, we then want to pick this up. We want to put down the other tank over here and then tell that exporter to export enderpearls. And so that should do the same thing, but put the resident ender on this side. And at that point, I'm hopeful that we can put both those down like so. Beautiful. So we do run the risk, of course, with something like this, that eventually, if we use like all of our destabilized redstone or all of our resident ender, then this tank will form into one tank and they will be mixed, which is less than ideal. Why not switch the tanks to the machines? I just think it looks cool having the two tanks next to each other, but with different liquids in it. Oh, it's done. Okay, perfect. I was a little worried there for a second. The server did just restart. I thought that maybe this wouldn't finish, but I guess it finished before the server restart happened. So our quest for a block of awakened draconium is done. Fantastic. All right. So a little bit of, communication with the Twitch chat. And we have a setup. So these two tanks at the front here are now just for show. So they're full of resident ender and destabilized redstone, but they're not actually going to be used for anything. What's happening now is all of the resident ender and destabilized redstone that's made in these magma crucibles is now being moved via XNet to these tanks here and here. These tanks are not connected, so there's no chance of them, messing up like these tanks could if these got empty. And so now these both have external storages on them. And so finally, we should now be able to teach our system how to use the fluid infuser that we have here to automate the creation of Signalum and Enderium. So let's put you down there. Let's grab a crafter. I feel like we should probably a little while ago have taught our system how to make crafters. Nevertheless, if we take one of those, we can put it down right about here. Let's make sure there's an XNet connector on the back of this, or at least on the bottom, actually. like so. And let's make sure that guy has some power. Insert. And we'll also set that to, of course, extract stacks on the loot chest table. So what we should be able to do now is over here, if we get rid of this crafting recipe, if we were to, for example, shift-click in the recipe for Signalum, that should work. You'll see on the left here, it looks like it's just the ingot. If you toggle to fluids, you'll see it is also putting the required fluid in there. And so I'm fairly certain that because we have access to the fluid, if we put this in like so, we should now be able to request, let's say, 10 Signalum. It says it's missing destabilized redstone. I haven't changed the guys here, the external storage. Those need to be set to fluid and fluid. There we go. And so now, if we go and we request 10 Signalum and start, it's going to send all of the required stuff to here, I would hope. It is perfect. And then right now it's pretty slow, but much like with all of the other machines here, we can grab some of the speed upgrades and also, I guess, some of the energy upgrades as well. Put both those in. That's going to make it faster. Obviously, as we get more power, we can put even more of those in. In fact, 60 RF per tick is not too much. We could put a few more speed upgrades in there at 91 redstone flux per tick. But now this is going to make Signalum automatically for us, and we can request it. On top of that, we could go ahead at this point and teach our system how to make Signalum gears. Like so, and throw that in over there. And at that point, we should also be able to teach it how to make the Signalum upgrade kit, because it should already know how to make Electrum gears. It knows now how to make Signalum, and we already have Cryothium dust taught as well. So if we put that in over here, and then we can do the exact same thing, of course, with Enderium, teach it this. And again, the fluid is there. We do have to teach it how to make the lead platinum alloy. This one is really going to be the downfall of us, I think, because right now we don't have platinum. Yeah, we have one platinum, which is not much at all. So I think in a future stream, we probably want to look at setting up like a system to make platinum. I think is it granite that we get platinum from? Andesite. So we probably want to set up a system that that produces and dissolves a ton of platinum. We'll probably do something similar to what we've done kind of over here, where we'll have like a system that produces platinum. It takes everything else out, but then deposits the platinum into a like a prim drawer at the bottom. At that point, we can kind of always have a backlog of platinum ingots, I guess, if we wanted to, for when we need Enderium. For now though, let's also go ahead and teach our system, I guess, real quick how to make the conversion kit for Signalum, but I don't know if that's necessarily worth it, given that fairly soon I'm hoping to get the Enderium version. So for now, let's go ahead and request like 10. Oh wait, you don't know how to make Electrum gears? Oh, you don't. Okay, let me Electrum gear. Let's teach you that real quick. And then, yeah, I think what we'll do for now is we'll just request like 10 Signalum upgrade kits. And we can begin putting those on all of our machines around the base to make things faster, right? Specifically things like our very loud sawmill over here. Making that faster is going to make us even more fighter grow, which is going to keep things like these growing, and is going to hopefully stop us from running into backlogs later on down the line. While we wait for those to finish, cycling back around to this quest line here, we do now have 4 blocks of awakened draconium, and so we should be able to get this here up and running. So if we get, I think it was 4 of you, as well as 1 nether star, and then 4 awakened draconium ingots. Let me check that recipe. It's 5 awakened draconium ingots, but the rest of that is correct. So let's do not that. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait. We need more, we need more crafting injectors. We only have 7, and this recipe requires 9. That should be fine, because earlier we did make enough injectors. So if we just take 2 more of these, put those in here, and then grab the diamonds, the draconium blocks, the draconic cores, and the wyvern cores, we should be good to go. All right. So two more of these Wyvern Fusion crafting injectors later. And I think that should be enough for us to complete this recipe here. Yeah, let's try that again. So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of you. Nether Star's going in there. And then we just need 4 Wyvern cores, which we have. 1, 2, 3, 4. And there we go. So that is going to somewhat slowly, but actually not that slowly. It's slower than the creation of the crafting injectors, but a lot faster than the creation of the awakened draconian blocks. That is going to get us the awakened cores. And that means, Chad, the next time we can come back and we can craft up our extreme crafting table. Very quickly, I think we are going to want to get the neutron collectors. These don't require power, but do just passively generate tiny piles of neutrons, which we are going to need going forward, presumably. And so we want to get those going, I think, as soon as possible. I think next time, though, before we start getting too far ahead of ourselves into this final quest line, I think next time we'll come back and we will reassess our power situation. Right now, it's been fairly obvious throughout the course of today's stream that we're not producing enough power. Well, we're producing kind of enough to get by, but not really enough to get by easily, right? Things are a little strained at the moment. And so I think we definitely are going to want to look at upping our power generation, whether that be through a bigger fission reactor, maybe a fusion reactor, maybe, some other form of power generation. And there we go. All right. And with that, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up today's stream there.